Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series of control system. In this video, I'll be deriving an expression for delay time. In the previous session, I have discussed what do you mean by delay time. It is one of the time domain specification. Let us recall the definition of delay time. It is the time required for the response to reach 50% of the steady state value for the very first time. I mean, it is the time taken for the response to reach 50% for the very first time. That's the definition of delay time. As you can observe, this is a 50% of the total response C of T. So TD is nothing but the time taken for the response to reach 50% of the response. Okay, or 50% of the final value. That is called delay time. Now I would like to derive an expression for delay time. So here also you can able to observe the waveform of second order underdamped system. Here you can able to figure out the delay time TD. See, the time taken to reach the 50% of the response or 50% of the final value of the response for the very first time. That is called a delay time TD. And in the last session, I have explained the expression also. As you can observe, the expression of delay time that is given by TD is equal to 1 plus 0.7 zeta divided by omega n, where zeta is called a damping ratio and omega n is known as natural frequency of oscillation, which is expressed in terms of radian per second. Now let us derive an expression for delay time. Let us go to the mathematical expression for delay time. Let's derive an expression for delay time. You know that delay time is one of the important time domain specification. You have to recall the definition of delay time. It is the time taken for the response to reach 50% of the final value for the very first time. And also, you know the general expression for the second order system for underdamped system. That is equal to C of T equal to 1 minus e to the power minus zeta omega n t divided by square root of 1 minus zeta square into sine omega dt plus theta, where zeta is known as damping ratio, omega n is called the natural frequency of oscillation, and omega is nothing but damped frequency of oscillation. Theta, there is an expression, so I'll let you know the value of theta. So this is a general expression which we have already derived for second order underdamped system, where C of T is the output, that means response. Clear? Now what you can do is, let us recall the definition of delay time. While recalling the definition of delay time, so we need to equate T is equal to TD. So the time becomes delay time. Whenever time becomes delay time, C of TD becoming C of T, or else you can call C of T become C of T. Better write C of T is equal to C of TD. Clear? So what is the value of C of TD? Of course, the value of C of TD, that is equal to 0.5, or you can call 50%. Okay, you can directly recall the value of C of TD, that is equal to 50%. It is nothing but 0.5. So I have written the same, C of TD is equal to 0.5. So do one thing, you can see the equation number 1. In spite of C of TD, please to put 0.5. So I am going to put in spite of C of TD, that is equal to 0.5. Okay, because I recall the definition of delay time, 1 minus e to the power minus zeta omega n into TD divided by square root of 1 minus zeta square into sine omega d into TD plus theta, that is equal to 0.5. So try to solve once again. Okay, you can able to solve. 1 is available in the LHS and 0.5 is locating at RHS. So further simplification, I'll be getting e to the power minus zeta omega n TD divided by square root of 1 minus zeta square into sine omega d TD plus theta, that is equal to 0.5. It is absolutely right. Now I need to calculate the value of TD. How to apply the value of TD? How to get the value of TD? So is there any technique? Yes, of course, there is a technique that is called linear approximation principle in engineering mathematics. So you can use the linear approximation principle. If you use the linear approximation principle, you can able to get the approximate value of TD. I'll let you know the approximate value of TD here. So where TD is known as delay time. So let me solve that particular value of TD. And finally, you will be getting the expression such as TD is equal to 1 plus 0.7 zeta divided by omega n. So you know the value of omega n. It is called a natural frequency of oscillation, which is expressed in terms of radian per second, where zeta is known as damping ratio. Here zeta, that value will be less than 1 because of underdamped system. So this is the final expression for delay time. In this session, I have given a brief idea about delay time. It is one of the important time domain specification, and I could recall the definition of delay time. Afterwards, I have derived the final expression for delay time for underdamped second order system. Finally, thank you very much for watching this video.